Hey folks, Mike here from Ollie, and today we're diving into something pretty exciting in the world of WordPress, synced patterns and partially synced patterns. Now, if you've been following along with our other videos, you know that patterns are a game changer for building websites quickly and easily. But synced patterns, they take things to a whole new level. Imagine being able to update a piece of content across your entire site with just one edit. That's the power of synced patterns. And partially synced patterns give you even more flexibility by letting you keep some parts of your pattern consistent while customizing others. They're kind of like WordPress design components. So whether you're a seasoned WordPress pro or just getting started with block themes like Ollie, understanding these features is going to save you a ton of time and headaches. So let's hop into WordPress and take a closer look at how you can design and build smarter with Ollie and synced patterns. All right, folks, so here I am in WordPress, and as usual, I'm going to be using the Ollie block theme for this demo. You can get the Ollie block theme for free at olliewp.com. It's one of the quickest ways to get started with block themes and full site editing and patterns and global styles and all of this new technology. So what I'm going to do real quick is just create two pages to get started with the demo, and we're going to look at how to use synced patterns and partially synced patterns with a testimonial area. So let's hop over into the editor, and just real quickly, I'm going to open up the Ollie Pro pattern library and select a layout. We have just tons of patterns and full page designs in here that you can use to quickly build out beautiful websites. So I'm going to scroll down, and you can see we have a testimonial section here, and I want to use that as the example. So I'm going to save that. And then I'm going to here as well and build out another page. Just go into that same collection so that we get the similar styles and use this services page. Insert pattern. Just like that, we have two beautifully designed pages ready to customize. So let's hop back over to the homepage. This is great because I was able to just throw this design on the page and here it is, ready to customize, ready to go. Looks great. The problem is for something like testimonials, where I have on this part of the website, this homepage, I might have them on multiple pages. I might have multiple testimonials on the same page. And so we have kind of testimonials everywhere. The problem is, like, what if I want to come in and change the way this testimonial is designed, right? Because say I get these on the page and I want to come back and change this. Maybe I want to change the border radius and make this font size smaller. Well, I would have to come in here on each one and I'd have to change the border radius here. I'd have to click here and click this tab again and do it and click this and do it a third time and then change the font size for each one. It just becomes a very taxing process and it's very time consuming. And then there's no way of controlling these on every page. What would I have to copy and paste that? So that's just not an ideal workflow. That's where the power of synced patterns and partially synced patterns comes in, because we can use that to effectively turn this testimonial box into a component, right? We can set the design and then turn some of the fields editable so that it can consume the content without touching the design. And then if we want to come and customize the design later, we can customize it in a central place, and then that design will be propagated throughout wherever this pattern is used, the synced pattern. Let's go ahead and just hop in and just create a synced pattern and see what that process is like. So I'm going to use this tree view. I almost always work with this tree view just because it's a lot easier to select things. So you'll see me in here a lot and I just build a lot quicker with it. I'm going to open this menu here and click create a pattern. Let's just call this testimonial. And by default, this is clicked. We'll just make that synced. Okay, so it just refreshed and you see it gave it this purple label, which means it's more of a global element. And so that means it's a synced pattern. Okay, let's see what that looks like to take that. So it's a synced pattern, which means anytime you change the content or the design of this, it's going to change it everywhere. So let's go ahead and paste that here and paste that here. And let's see what happens if we go in and edit that synced pattern. Let's say I change the text to some lorem ipsum, change his name to Mike, and save, and then let's go back. Come down here, you can see that all of the instances of that synced pattern have now changed. which is great. That works well for instances where you want that. Maybe you have some a contact box with some hours, restaurant hours, or open and close hours, or things like that, contact information that is global and won't change. That works for that because then you can change that information in one place and it propagates it out to your site. But for things like this, we need to be able to change the text on this testimonial box and the name and the avatar. We need to be able to change that for every testimonial. So this doesn't work. So we can go back in here, click on this testimonial again, and we're going to click Edit Original. And then if I come over here and click the paragraph, click that in the tree view just to make sure I have it clicked. And then if I come down to the advanced panel, we have enable overrides and it says allow changes to this block throughout instances of this pattern. So I'm going to click that and then it's going to ask me to name this field, this override. Let's just call this text enable. Okay, we're going to continue on. I'm going to click the image and I'm going to click enable overrides and we'll call this avatar and click this and we'll call this name and click this and we'll call this title, company, something like that. All right, now let's save that and let's hop back in and scroll down. All right, now let's do the same. Let's try to change some of the content and see what happens. And see, I was able to do that. We'll leave that one like that. That. This last name. This Ollie. Spelled my own name wrong. I'll make this Patrick Posner, partner in crime. Ollie Pro. And we'll just leave that one. And you can see I'm able to change these fields without modifying anything else. The design is going to remain the same. Let's change these images out real quick. And lists. And this. And let's just this one real quick. And we'll make that. Okay. Save that. So what just happened there was I was able to change the content of this pattern and it took on the content and was able to change out the images and kept the design of that intact like a component. Now I can have full control over this pattern and anywhere it's used, I can send design changes to that without worrying about messing with the content. So let's see what that looks like. So say I want to come back in here now and I want to change the design a little bit more. Let's edit the original. Maybe this font size is a little too big. Make it smaller. And let's click on the group and maybe give it a box shadow. Save that. Go back. Scroll down again. And you can see that the font size is now smaller. And we have that nice box shadow. I don't know if it'll come through on the video, but it's very subtle. And we have our original content is still intact. So that's awesome. That gives us the power to work a little smarter, to be able to be smarter with our content, kind of componentize it, and then have these little or big design components that we can use throughout our site. So you can really start to think creatively about how to use synced patterns and partially synced patterns to really create a bit of a design system within your site. Let's take this to another page. I'm going to copy this testimonials row and I'm just going to copy this whole thing and come over to this other studio page onto the bottom here and paste it here as well. Okay, now you can see I have these component instances, these partially synced pattern instances, and I can do the same here. I can customize this content here and change out the images and that'll work as expected. So I have these now on two different pages and the content is just like I want it. And then I can change the design from one central place. Now I can come in here, even on this page, you can change it anywhere if you click this edit original button. So I can change the design here. So let's just do it one more time. Let's make that font big again. save it. See down there that the font is big again. So I was able to control that design from right here within this page, and then the changes were spread out everywhere. So that is the gist of sync patterns and partially sync patterns. Now, the caveat is that if you scroll up here, not all blocks have these overrides enabled on them. So you don't have that setting on all blocks yet. For example, this is an icon block. This is not a WordPress core block. This is from the icon block plugin. And I do not have, if I click that, you can see here, there is not a panel that says enable overrides here, which would be great because then I could turn this into a component and use different icons within that partially synced pattern. Now, you could, as a workaround, you could just use an image here instead of this icon block. You could use images and change them out that way. But for this example, I do have this. And I did want to call out the fact not all blocks have this enabled. But as more do get this feature enabled, you can imagine the possibilities. Like I said, this is one of those features where you don't realize how powerful it is until you've started using it. Or maybe you've built out your site and you have these smart patterns everywhere that you can easily customize and change the designs. And I think one interesting way of using it is instead of like the old school days of creating a full website in WordPress, and then later on you go to change the theme and you have to redo everything. With this, if you set some of these patterns up smartly at the beginning and turn these into partially synced patterns, which are basically components, you may not have to redesign your site with a brand new theme as regularly. You might just come in here and change the styles on these groups or these sections. Maybe you have a full section that is a sync pattern. Then you can just customize the design that way instead of having to swap themes all the time. And if you have something like Ollie and Ollie Pro, which comes with tons of patterns, well, then you have just infinite possibilities. So again, that is the power of synced and partially synced patterns. Hopefully they come up with a better name for that. That is a mouthful. But I do think there's a lot to learn here and there's a lot to dig into. Get the Ollie block theme. It's totally free and you can start practicing with these patterns. All right, folks, that's the lowdown on synced and partially synced patterns in WordPress. They're pretty cool, right? I mean, they really are game changers when it comes to managing content across your site efficiently. If you're using Ollie and Ollie Pro, you've got a whole library of patterns at your fingertips to start experimenting with. So go ahead, dive in, start playing around with them. And trust me, once you get the hang of it, you'll wonder how you ever managed without them. All right, folks, thanks for hanging out for a bit. I'll see you next time.